Hey people, it's Sunday, August 30th. It's about 2:40 p.m. and the temperature is about 23 degrees Celsius, so not too hot, which I'm liking. And right now I'm standing here in front of a house that might look familiar to fans of a certain show about vampires. Anyone who watches the show What We Do in the Shadows on FX might recognize this as the vampire mansion that they live in, which on the show is supposed to be located in Staten Island, New York, but in reality is here on Pape Avenue in East End, Toronto. And this house is currently undergoing renovations. It's a pretty historic house. It even has a plaque that I will check out here. Cranfield House, 1902. So this is the vampire mansion from What We Do in the Shadows. Maybe in the future sometime they'll erect another plaque describing its significance in the world of vampire fiction. So let's take a walk around the other side. Quite the enormous old house, that's for sure. I wanted to come and check this out because What We Do in the Shadows is definitely my top three favorite shows right now, in the top three. Just hilarious. If you haven't seen it before, definitely check it out. It's just every other line is hilarious on that show. And there's actually another location here in the city that the show uses, and I'm gonna make my way down there too. So that's it. What We Do in the Shadows Vampire Mansion. Let's get one last look here. I can get the whole thing. So right now I'm walking south on Pape Avenue. There's a pedestrian bridge up ahead that has an awesome view of the skyline. already see it, but we're not at the top yet. Good spot to watch trains also, if you're into that. Both VIA and GO Transit use this rail corridor. Probably wouldn't have to wait too long before a train goes by, but I don't know if I want to stand here and test that theory. The Pape Avenue resumes here after a brief interruption from the rail corridor. And here we have Gerrard Square Mall, which is an old shopping mall, old school. It's kind of a more urban design shopping mall since it's basically jammed into this dense inner city neighborhood, although it still does have surface parking, but on the other side there's a multi-level garage. And the mall inside is multi-level as well. People in Toronto kind of like to make fun of this mall. It's not highly regarded. But saying that, I'm sure it's plenty handy to a lot of people who live in this neighborhood. We are on Gerrard Street East. Just take a little brief journey down here for a few minutes, and then I'll be turning south again. Right now we're actually heading west on Gerrard Street East to can be kind of confusing sometimes when you're describing the street you're on and the direction you're going when they seem to contradict each other. Here we are going underneath that rail corridor. And it sounds like a train is going over right now, actually. To cross here first before I turn south, just so I could get a better look at this. This is the Real Jerk, which is a very popular restaurant in Toronto, and it was actually the location for another well-known entertainment phenomenon. Drake and Rihanna shot the music video for the song Work in this restaurant. You might know it. Goes something like work, 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 work. That's pretty much all the lyrics as far as I know. All right, gonna head south now. We're on Carlaw Avenue. So this street, Carlaw Avenue, is pretty interesting since it's lined with old factory buildings that are no longer being used as factories. They've given way to other uses, and in addition some new condo developments have been built in amongst the old factory buildings. So yeah, most of these old factories date from the 1910s, around there, 1910 to 1920. So here we are at Dundas in Carlaw, and apparently this monument is called the signature marker. It was just newly installed recently. A couple of great old factory buildings. I wonder if that phone still works. This is the Wrigley factory, or the former. And I guess, I'm not sure if it's residential now. I think it is. I think it's part of this condo development now. Toy factory. Yeah, think your great-great-grandmother might have played with a doll made at that factory back in the day. Or maybe not great-great, maybe just great. Or if you're old, maybe just your grandmother. Keep pulling ahead of those two, but then I stop to look at something and then they get ahead of me again. Then I have to get ahead of them again. The new downtown relief subway line was originally, or at one time, slated to run underneath Carlaw Avenue here for part of its route, but I'm not sure if that's still the case. I think now it looks like they're going to be running it along the rail corridor, alongside the rail corridor, as an above-ground route. But the area residents don't like that idea, and they want it to stay underground. So we'll see what happens with that. So right now we're at Queen Street East. Leslieville neighborhood. We're going to keep walking south on Carlaw. Because that second location for the What We Do in the Shadows show is up ahead. It's a little breezy right now, so if my voice gets drowned out by the wind every now and then, I apologize. I still need to get one of those little foam wind guards for my camera. I should get on that. Got a nice mix of housing, old housing styles here. Got some couple detached, got some semi-detached, got some row houses. My favorite type is row houses. Of which there are actually a lot of row houses in Toronto, so I'm pretty happy about that. Alright, so we're here at Eastern Avenue. It's a fairly industrial looking area, a mix of residential and industrial. Pretty old, a bit off the beaten path. Just up ahead, there's the site where they do the on-location shooting for the outdoor scenes that are supposed to take place on the grounds of the Vampire Mansion, but they actually take place over here, and the Vampire Mansion itself is only used for exterior shots when they just want to show the mansion. Everything else that happens outside in the yard of the mansion actually was shot here in this vacant lot. Eastern Ave is basically just a traffic corridor. So as soon as I can cross, let's see what I was trying to show you. Here's the lot where they shoot the outdoor scenes that are supposed to be in front of their mansion. And this house across the street with the stars on it, if you watch the show, whenever they're looking across the street from the mansion, this is the house that you see. So, you know, in reality, they're nowhere near each other. It's kind of the illusion of show business. So now we'll just head west along Eastern Avenue. It's another contradiction in directions. Very gritty stretch heading down to the Portlands area. I did another video over a year ago where I walked down there by the big smokestack. Yeah, so this is another stretch of old factory buildings and warehouses. Although it hasn't been condo-fied yet the way Carlaw Avenue has. At least not to the same extent. I think there's a few that have popped up. Such as right here, condos, lofts. glad they're partially preserving these old buildings when they redevelop them. This is a great old massive building. I should say, two great old massive buildings. Dibble Street, like Dibble. How is that even a word? There's a GO train. Got some boarded up houses that they burned years ago. This area here is always a bit of a pedestrian, you know, black hole. Here we have the Unilever plant and a VIA train going by. I've never gotten up close to this Unilever site. It seems like whenever I'm in this area, it just seems inaccessible. I know there's a way to get to it, but I just haven't bothered to take the time to actually do it. Oh, this might be a dead end, you know? I remember years ago I tried to walk through here and I couldn't. But I'm wondering if anything has changed, but I don't think anything's changed. Yeah, here we are at the Don Valley Parkway. And unless I want to scale this fence and run across the highway, I don't think I'm going anywhere. So I guess I'll head back this way. I covered pretty much everything I wanted to see on this walk anyway. I just wanted to go between the two locations for the show. And the rest of this has just been a little bit of wandering. So I'll just end the video and then try to make my way back over here. So I hope you enjoyed this little look at the world of what we do in the shadows here in Toronto. You know, if you did enjoy, if you're a fan of the show, or if not, you know, anyway, still like, subscribe, comment, tell your friends, all of the above. And hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. And by all means, keep checking back because I will continue. We'll catch you next time.